Hello students, in today's class we are going to continue our class. Okay, so I am going to explain the topic, continuing the topic, that is the types of marketing environment. Okay, types of marketing environment. So what I have said you in the previous class is the types of marketing environment and micro environment factors. These two are the same topics. Okay, so there are some micro environment factors who are affecting the marketing. Okay, marketing. Micro environment factors. Micro environment factors. Okay, so there are six factors. They are the six factors. These are all what? External factors. So all departments within organization have a potential to positively or negatively impact company's objectives. So these factors are generally under control of the firm. So these have to coordinate with each other, but external factors cannot be governed by the firm. So there are some factors which will be governing the companies. So but there are some factors which are not, which cannot be governed by the companies. Okay, so konni factors untai, like oka company lo company internal management gurinchi gaani, various departments or purchasing departments untai, research departments untundi, and development departments will be there. So ee departments ni internal, ivanni internal part of the company, indulo they can manage, but outside there are some factors which cannot be governed by the company. What are those factors? There are six factors. First is suppliers. Okay, this is the first point, which is the suppliers. So this factor affects the marketing. Okay, suppliers, marketing, suppliers, marketing intermediaries, marketing intermediaries, competitors, fourth is customers, fifth is general public, sixth is company. Okay, so these are the four factors. Okay, these are the four factors. What is marketing intermediaries? First one, second is, sorry, first is suppliers, second is marketing intermediaries, third is competitors, fourth is customers, and fifth is general public, and sixth is company. So what does it mean? That means, what is the first one is suppliers. So how it is affecting the marketing? So marketing is always affected by these factors. Okay, these factors. So what is the factor? It is the suppliers. First one is suppliers. So the suppliers comprise all the business firms or individuals who provide new raw materials, components, and semi-finished goods to be used in production, or even sell finished goods of the organization. So suppliers, what they do, suppliers em chestu untaru, they will be, what they will be doing, they will provide the raw material, components, and semi finished goods to be used for production, or even they sell finished products of the organization. So supply chestu untaru villu, suppliers will be there, they will be supplying the raw materials, they will be supplying the finished goods for the
production, and they will sell, they will also sell the finished products of the organization. So basically a company depends on so many suppliers. Okay, a company depends on numerous suppliers, either in capacity of a buyer of input or a producer to wholesaler and retailer. So there will be a seller, supplier will be there, okay, who will be supplying all the finished goods, materials, and also he will be supplying the goods, and he will be supplying the materials, and he will be supplying all the finished goods to the public or to the wholesaler. Suppliers and all, definitely they should be there. These are what outside the company activity, they are the external factors for the marketing purpose. So these are also, this is also one kind of a micro environment factors, and also type of marketing environment. Okay, so that these are the external factors, they will be affecting the, and marketing is affected by these factors, and these factors are also affected by the marketing. So suppliers' role is very much important in this factor, because the suppliers need to supply all the raw materials, finished goods to the wherever they need, the wherever the requirement is there. So the raw material, why the raw material is used? Raw material is used for the manufacturing of any product. So who will bring the raw material to the company? Means the suppliers will supply the raw material sometimes, and also the supplier will be supplying all the required products. Sometimes the suppliers will supply the finished goods products also. Okay, so the buyer supplier relationship is one of the mutual economic interdependence. So there will be a buyer and supplier. So buyer and supplier both are what, interdependent. Both are kone vallu supply chese vallu. There should be a buyer and the supplier will supply to the buyer. So the supplier and buyer, the both are what, they are both interdependent with each other. So what, they are interdependent with each other, and both parties rely on one another for their commercial well-being. Okay, both parties are seeking stability and security from their relationship. Factors in the supplier's environment are subject to change. Sometimes what happens, they both are dependent on each other, so the other factors, whatever will be affecting the business, that will be affected by the, that will also affect this relationship. So there should be some security for the buyer and supplier relationship. So the factor in the supplier environment are subject to change. Sometimes the factors in the suppliers and buyer, they get changes sometimes in some factors. So the relationship has to be maintained between the buyer and the supplier. So if the, for instance, if shortage of raw material or sudden increase in raw material prices forces the suppliers to raise the prices. So sometimes when the supplier is supplying to everything, raw materials and what are the goods required, he will be supplying to the company. So he will be supplying for the manufacturing. So sometimes when the prices increases, okay, when the raw material prices, when there is a shortage in the raw material, okay, when there is a shortage in the raw material ki, then the manufacturer, the suppliers em chestaru, they will be increasing the prices of the raw materials. Okay, prices, he will be increasing the prices of the raw materials. So he will be material forces suppliers to raise the prices. Okay, he will force the suppliers to raise the prices. So what happens if the prices increases? Okay, if the prices increases, okay, for instance, shortage of raw material, or if there is any sudden increase in raw materials, the prices, what happens, the prices forces what, suppliers to the rise in the prices, or an industrial dispute may affect delivery of material to the buyer company. Okay, so So there will be a supplier company and there will be a buyer company. Okay, so when there are disputes between both these companies, or there are any disputes between in the industrial, if there is any industrial dispute, it can affect the delivery. Okay, delivery of these raw materials, like supplier oka industry konedi oka industry. So veela madhyalo edaina disputes unte, edaina problem vaste akkada delivery ki problem avutundi supply cheyadaniki. So suppliers tho relationship should be maintained, but some factors they will affect the relationship. What are those? Sometimes the prices may force, prices increase ayinappudu, raw material increase, raw material takku unnappudu prices increase chesestaru suppliers, and vaa supply cheyaru raw material takku undani cheppi companies ki, what he will be, they will be doing, they will be increasing the prices because there is a shortage in the raw material. And if there is any dispute between these industries, okay, they will not deliver the raw material. Sometimes it can affect the delivery procedure. So and any unexpected development in the supplier's environment can have a immediate and potentially serious effect on the company's commercial operations and productions. Okay, and it is crucial for a firm to monitor potential changes in the supplier's environment and have contingency plans ready to deal with adverse development hampering production activity. So sometimes what happens, if there is any requirement that sudden development has to be done for the production, so continuously they need to adapt to that environment, and they need to do the development procedure activity continually. They should not stop the development procedure so it is crucial for a company to monitor potential changes in the suppliers environment. Okay, the company should monitor the changes in the supplier's environment and should have the plans ready to deal with the any adverse developments production activity. So the company and the suppliers both need to be ready at any situation, whatever arises in the whatever comes in the part. So the second is work marketing intermediaries. So these marketing intermediaries, what these are also the other fact, this is also one of the other factor. Okay, this is also one of the other factor, how it has been affecting, okay, how it has been affecting the marketing. So the other one is marketing intermediaries. So marketing intermediaries are the interdependent individuals or organizations that directly help in the free flow of goods and services between marketing organization and customers. So suppliers untaru, okay, marketing okay, suppliers will be there for doing the in this marketing, suppliers will be the factor, and the other factor is what, marketing intermediaries. So who are the marketing intermediaries? Okay, there will be a retailer, there will be a wholesaler and customer. Okay, retailer, wholesaler, customer. So retailer untaru, wholesaler untaru, distributors untaru, and at the end time lo customer will be there. Okay, at the end time customer will be there. So these are the intermediary factors, these are the intermediary factors for intermediary marketing factors. So there will be the wholesaler, retailer, distributor and customer. So marketing intermediaries are the independent individuals or organizations that directly help in the free flow of goods and services between marketing organizations and customers. So these are two types, namely merchant and agent. So merchant middleman can be wholesaler and a retailer. Okay, so generally who are the intermediaries? There are two types, they are merchant and the agent. So merchant middleman can be wholesaler and retailer. Okay, merchant ki madhyalo evaru untaru, there will be a wholesaler and the retailer. Okay, so generally these are two types, what are they, namely merchant and agent. So merchant middleman can be wholesaler and retailer. Okay, merchant middleman can be wholesaler and retailer. So agent middlemen are important part of the distribution network and re important services in different capacities. So basically what happens, there are wholesalers and retailers. Okay, so in merchant and agent, merchant middleman can be wholesaler and retailer. So these are the marketing intermediaries. Okay, marketing intermediaries. Agent middlemen are important part of the distribution network. Okay, agent middleman area is important for the distribution network and services. So organizations typically rely on what? Banks and capacities and other sources to finance their operations. So what happens, these marketing intermediaries, majhelo some should be there, some people will be there who will be acting like an agent and who will be supplying the goods and who will be acting as a agent between the customer and the retailer, and there will be a middleman, there will be agent, and there will be a, these are what are the intermediary factors. Third one is customers. Okay, customers. So you know customer, who are they? Customer are the like general customers. So a customer may be a individual or household. Okay, customer may be an individual or household. An organization that purchases a product for use in the production of other products, or an organization that purchases a product for resale at a profit. So a customer may be an individual or household. An organization that purchases a product for use in the production of other products, or an organization that purchases a product for resale at a profit. Okay, so that means customer is a individual person or a household, or a household, it can be you and me also. Okay, so an organization that purchases a product for use in the production of other products, or an organization that purchases a product for resale at a profit. So sometimes the customers, what happens, sometimes they will be reselling the products. Okay, reselling the products. So they can, an organization that purchases a product for the use in the production of other products of an organization that purchases a product. So sometimes some organizations, what they do, they purchases the same product and they do the resale of the products. Okay, they do the reselling for the products. And this customer factor of a marketing micro environment has great influence on marketing decisions. So marketing specialist or marketers develop a market message to appeal to a company's individual customer needs. The target may be grouped, like how they are being targeted, like customer, market, individuals and household buying the product for consumption. So customer, market, individuals or households buy the products for consumption. So customer will be there, he will be purchasing the products and for the consumptions. So industrial market organizations buying for producing other goods and services for the purpose of either earning profits or for fulfilling other objectives or both. Sometimes these resellers, market organizations buy goods and services with a view to sell them to others for a profit. So these may be selling intermediaries and retailers. So government and other non-profit market, the institutions buying goods and services, okay, in order to produce public services. So they transfer these goods and services to those who need them for consumption in most of the cases. So international market and individuals and organizations, what they do of the other countries, buy for their consumption or industrial use or both. So they may be foreign custom consumers, producers, resellers and governments. And the other one is what? Fourth one is competitors. So competitors are the rival business companies in the, what they do, effort to satisfy the markets and consumers demand. Competitors are the what? They are rivals, business firms in the efforts. Who are the competitors? They are the rivals. They are what? They are the competitors in the market. They will be fighting with each other for doing the business in the market, to get the good name in the market, to stand at a number one position in the market. They will be fighting for the number one position. They are the competitors. You know who are the customers. Third is competitors. Okay, third is what? Competitors. Fourth is customers. You know who are the competitors and you know who are the customers. Okay, you don't know about the suppliers and marketing intermediaries that I have explained you, and who are the competitors. Okay, so competitors are the rival business firms. They are the rivals in the business firms in the effort to satisfy the markets and consumers' demand. Since these are competing with each other, the marketing decisions of one firm not only influence consumer responses in the marketplace but also affect the marketing strategies of other competitors. So since these are competing with each other, the marketing decisions of one firm not only influence consumer responses in the marketplace but also affect the marketing strategies of other competitors. So what is this? It is there like, if the one decision of the one company and one decision of the other company will automatically affect the consumers, because they are the competitors, they are the rivals, they are the competitors in the company.